I'm now going to change gears and move this over to Gautam from PVR. I'm sure a lot of people are interested in seeing what the service sector challenges are coming about. Over to you, Gautam.
Thank you so much. First of all, some great learnings, and Vibha and Mukundan both covered lots of the points that I wanted to talk about. But these are all words of wisdom, and I'm sure people who are listening would take note of these points. And I don't want to repeat them, but where I would sort of come in is, how is our business different? And that sort of makes it very exciting and interesting, because, you know, every time a crisis hits, people say, this is one industry which is going to go down. Piracy, we were supposed to be wiped out. DVD came, people said people will stop watching movies. Then came IPL, and people said, oh God, cricket is going to completely take over, and who's going to be watching the movies? But somehow we survive. We survive because people don't understand the one simple thing, that entertainment is actually an essential commodity. It's not a non-essential commodity. A lot of people say you won't die if you don't watch a film, which is a fact, but you will actually die of boredom if you don't watch a film or don't do anything. The second question nowadays, every day that I'm getting to know is, you know, people are watching a lot of Netflix and Amazon and OTT. And so how are you going to sort of turn it around? And reality is, we are not running. We are not running the race, because the fact of the matter is, let us open and we'll show how what will happen. Because the fact is, I can just tell you, on the last day when we closed and when, you know, there were already some bit of talk around the virus spreading, we got 2,10,000 people. And this was with 50% of our cinemas, which were sort of locked down, and 50% were only operational. And yet we got 2 lakh people who said, damn it, and I'm going to come out and watch a film, because that's what life is all about. So eventually, yes, the fear became bigger, and we were the first to sort of close down, and we would perhaps be the last ones to possibly open. We are aware of that. But I think what we are doing is a couple of things. We're taking it right on our chin, and we've always believed that this industry has come up with something new, more innovative, more sharper, when the chips are down. And currently, the fact is, we believe it's slightly unfair to compare this whole OTT to cinema debate, simply because we are not on. The day we are on, I think you would see a huge amount of change. Having said that, going by what Vibha and Mukundan had sort of covered, I'll quickly talk about some of the key things that we did, and along the way, some of the key learnings. One, as I said, we continue to be optimistic, very, very optimistic about our industry, about our consumer. We are kind of talking and communicating with our consumer virtually once a week. We have a huge loyalty program of roughly about 1 crore and 10 lakh people. So we know exactly what that guy is doing. We are actually sending him recommendations for movies that he needs to be watching at home. And because we truly believe we are not in the business of showing movies. We are in the business of out-of-home entertainment. And we've completely redefined this space by how are all aspects of service coming. So today, when you ask a consumer, he's not come to PVR to watch a film. It's about his 3-hour holiday. He says, you know, I wanted to, today's a happy Father's Day, and I needed to be a good father, so I've got my family out. Today is happy Mother's Day, so I've got my mother to come and have a treat. So it's no longer about just the film. It's about great food. It's about great ambience. And somebody rightly asked us many years ago to say, why do you sort of end up spending so much money in your foyers? They look like 7-star hotels. And one of the reasons is because this is a doors to fantasy. When consumers walk in, they need to be transported to a different world. And I think PVR started that trend. Way back in 2004, PVR launched Gold Class Cinemas, which was all about recliner seats and fancy food. Could you have ever imagined a cinema chain selling sushi? We do that today. And we've got a chef from Hong Kong, Saito, one among the best in the world, who's sort of, set up a sushi brand for us. I was talking to the reporter the other day. She said, the last visit I had, I went to the cinema and I said, can I get pasta? And I was so excited to see pasta in your F&B listing. So I ordered for a pasta and the guy turned around and said, with red sauce or white sauce? He says, wow, what's happening? Where am I? So technically, the reality is that this is where I think a PVR and this entire industry has kind of graduated to. Some talk about it, some unknowingly has chartered into this territory, but we are really in out-of-home entertainment. And we believe that these are times when we need to again look back into every part of our value chain and see how we can sort of redefine it. So we're looking at new F&B, we're looking at getting rid of box offices completely, going all digital and 100% online. We are looking at more recliner seats, simply because the social distancing technically get met by recliners a lot better because they're wide and the other person is far away from you. So, and even in places like Muradabad, Vellore, the last row recliners sell much before the normal seats. So everyone, one of our consumers summed it up really well when he said, this is my 3-hour vacation. And we called it the moviecation. So we said, we are in the business of memories and moviecation. And so that's what we thoroughly believe. As we have a very, very strong and a large team with us. We have roughly about 14,000 people. Like Vibha said, we've insulated the minimum wage staff for the last 2 months, March and April. We paid them full salaries. All the brunt has largely been taken by the management team, and rightly so, I guess. But we are hoping that there would be some sort of a support to our industry by the government. And if that comes through, I think we'll be able to wade through this difficult time. As I said, we're doing a lot of great work with our film industry. If you notice, not a single release has gone to an OTT over the last 2 months. And that, we feel, is another great triumph of our business, simply because out of the 15,000 crore movie business that happened in India, still about 11 to 12,000 crores come out of the box office, the cinema halls. And that is something that we are very confident is not going to change. And consumers and our partners in the film business are determined to make that work. And wait and watch. When we open, we'll open with a bang. And all the basic things that everyone spoke about, social distancing and all of that, mask and doctor's checkup, and all of that will happen. We will graduate to a new form of being. I wait for a day when the government realizes that entertainment is surely an essential commodity, not a non-essential commodity. I leave it there and have Dilip take over from here.
Thank you, Gautam. You've really got me itching to go and watch a movie now. You've really pumped, I think, all of us. And you're making us think of all the times that we went out for movies together.